question today. What do you think teens deserve to be paid for a job in the adult workplace? Well, the state of Maine is looking at a proposal. It's a Republican-sponsored bill that would make employers there capable of paying teen workers $2 less than the minimum wage. They would get the lower wage, called a training wage, for up to the first 180 days on the new job. It would affect all workers under the age of 20. So we're talking 18, 19-year-olds, technically adults, in addition to younger teens being affected by that potentially. Now, critics are saying it's all part of an attempt to ease the state's child labor laws. There's also another proposal on the table that would allow 16 and 17-year-olds to work a little more and later into the night. The number of hours a teen could work on school nights would go up from 20 right now to 24 hours a week. They could work until 11 at night as well. Right now, the cutoff is 10 at night. That bill sponsor says it gives more options to employers to hire young people. They say the teens would get to work more hours so they could save more money for things such as college. Some Democrats, though, are saying it just means kids are working more for less money if this passes. We want to go to a caller. Brian joins us from Missouri. Hey there, Brian.
How are you?
I'm good, thanks. What do you think about this proposal?
I just absolutely think it's ridiculous, and it's another way of taking advantage of kids and not teaching them the values of just absolutely working for a good wage and, you know, giving them some insight to really work for a total common goal. And you had a caller earlier that said that employers would take advantage of teenagers, and now I hear the law is sponsored by a Republican, you know, which means to me just more bottom line for richer people and separation of, you know, poor and business owners. I was a former business owner, and you know what? I mean, I had a lot of 19 and 20-year-olds. I had a convenience store, and there was a lot of employees that I did pay lesser wages, and they're taking up the jobs of people that need to support their families, you know, to pay for their homes. A lot of people are losing their homes with the unemployment rate they are. So I totally agree that the law would take advantage of teenagers.
So you think this kind of law would be a win for employers but a lose for teenagers? Do you think there could be any advantage to teens under rules like this?
There's very little that a teenager could gain, and it just opens the gate for a gamut of employers. With me being a previous employer, I didn't take advantage of per se, but I did pay them less, of course, than a 30 or 40-year-old person, because I did have a conscience, and I did know that that these people had livelihoods and children and homes to take care of. So, you know, when you get a 19-year-old or an 18-year-old or a 17-year-old or whatever living at their house with their mom or dad or whatever like that, of course you're going to pay them less because you feel like that they didn't have the expenses that they needed that extra money.
Mm-hmm. Well, Brian, really appreciate your insight, especially as a former employer. Appreciate it very much. What do you people think? Listen to what Amy wrote to us. Amy wrote, kids are kids. That's why this law is for 16 and 17-year-olds. This law will allow them, not force them. It gives them an option. And at 16 and 17, they should be learning that life is about hard work and things won't be given to them. Jables writes, seeing as how I am 20 and in college, I can say that I wish I had worked more in high school. Would have helped. People saying kids need to be kids. Well, yeah, but others want to be teachers and doctors in the future, so they want to start saving now so they can reach that dream.